Hello, my dear students. How y'all? I hope you are enjoying the classes, and I hope that you have practiced well about our Newton's second law. What we have discussed in our second law? Let us revise once. In the Newton's second law, we have discussed that dP by dt is nothing but our external force. Means the rate of change of momentum is nothing but external force. We have discussed this. Can I write it like this? F external is equal to dP means change in momentum. Change in momentum by dt means time. Now, can I write this change in momentum like final momentum minus initial momentum by time is equal to our F external? Means whenever there is some change in momentum, final momentum minus initial momentum, whenever there is some change with respect to time, then we say that some force is exerted on the system. Or else, if some external force is exerted on the system, there will be some change in momentum. Ante external ga man medana force apply chesthe momentum lo change vastundi లేదా రావాలి, లేదా అక్కడ మొమెంటమ్ లో చేంజ్ వచ్చింది అంటే ఎక్స్టర్నల్ ఫోర్స్ అప్లై అయింది అని దాని అర్థం. నౌ షల్ వి డిస్కస్ దిస్ ఇన్ రివర్స్? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, దెర్ ఇస్ నో చేంజ్ ఇన్ ద మొమెంటమ్ మీన్స్ ఇఫ్ దిస్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో చేంజ్ మీన్స్ ఎఫ్ ఎక్స్టర్నల్ బికమ్స్ జీరో. అఫ్ కోర్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ నాట్ ట్రూ, బికాస్ ఇఫ్ దిస్ ఇస్ అ వాల్ అండ్ ది వాల్ ఈస్ ఎట్ రెస్ట్, ఐఎమ్ అప్లైయింగ్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ దిస్ వాల్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఐఎమ్ అప్లైయింగ్ ద ఫోర్స్, but as the wall is rigid, the wall cannot be displaced. While discussing the definition of a force, we have discussed the same. Force is a physical quantity which tries to change or actually change the state of the object. So here the force is there actually, and it is trying to displace the position of this wall, but it has failed because the force is insufficient. Means there is no change in momentum means it doesn't mean that the force is actually zero. It means that the force is insufficient. Okay, but let us see this in reverse. But if the force is zero, means what? Means I am not applying any force on this wall. Means what? If external is equal to zero, means I am going to represent this moment with P. P final minus P initial by time is equal to zero means there is no external force. If no external force is acting on the system, means P final is equal to P initial, means final momentum of the system is equal to initial momentum of the system. This is known as law of conservation of linear momentum. This is known as law of conservation of linear momentum. Today we are going to discuss about this linear momentum, and let us see in our real life where we are going to see this law of conservation of linear momentum. Let us see now. Number one, in general, assume that you are standing on a chair and try to jump from the chair. What happens? You move forward and the chair moves in the backward direction. You move in the forward direction and the chair moves in the backward direction. Why? Second one, imagine you are standing in a boat and you are jumping from the boat towards the seashore or bank of the river. What happens? You actually move forward and reach the bank of the river, and the boat moves in the backward direction. Second one. Let us see the third one. Whenever a police or a soldier fires a gun, what happens? They hold the gun very strongly, and sometimes they hold the gun so that the gun hits the shoulder. Why? What happens if they don't give shoulder support to the gun? What happens? The moment when the police fires the gun
moves in the forward direction. Bullet moves in the forward direction and the gun moves in the backward direction. We call this as recoil of gun. So the gun moves backward with some velocity. We call this as the recoil of a gun. This is a direct application of our law of conservation of linear momentum. Today we are going to discuss about it. And in Diwali or in any other occasion, if you blast a bomb, what happens? The bomb is initially at rest. It is kept somewhere. If it blasts, it turns out into some pieces. For example, at least two pieces. How do they move? They move in different directions. Why? So we are going to discuss all these cases. Based on these cases, we have several problems in our worksheet, and also we are going to solve those worksheet problems. Moreover, if you listen my concept, if you can understand my concept clearly, imagine this is a bomb which is at rest. Say its mass is capital M and it is at rest. In this case, what is its momentum? Zero. Now, due to its internal process, it blasts into two pieces. Say two pieces like this. Then what happens? For example, its mass is m1, its mass is m2. If it moves with a velocity v1, it moves with another velocity v2. Now, after blasting, what is our final momentum? Pf is equal to momentum of first piece and momentum of second piece. So what is the momentum of the first piece? Its mass and its velocity. What is the momentum of the second piece? Its mass and its velocity. Now see here, is there any external force? Did anyone came here and hit this, pushed it, pulled it? No. Hence we can say that there is no external force. As there is no external force, what about the initial and the final momentums? They are equal. Initial momentum is equal to final momentum. What was our initial momentum? Zero. What is our final momentum? M1 V1 plus M2 V2. From this, can I say that M1 V1 is equal to minus M2 V2? So what does it mean? It means that the momenta of two pieces are same. But as a momentum is a vector quantity, it has direction. If one piece is moving in the positive direction, another piece must move in the negative direction. Means that two pieces move apart in opposite directions with equal momenta, but not with equal velocity. I'm not saying that equal velocity, but with equal momentum, they are moving apart. From this, if you know the mass of the first part, if you know the mass of the second part, if you know the velocity of the first part, we can find the velocity of the second part. That is, V2 is given by M1 V1 by M2 with a negative sign. So these are our velocity of the second part we can find. Is it clear? In the problem, if he gives mass of the first body, velocity of the first body and velocity of the second body, then we can find the mass of the second body. Like this, we can find whatever the unknown quantities. The same concept can be used in case of a gun also. Recoiling of a gun, let us see that now. Imagine this is a gun with a bullet loaded. Imagine this is a gun and a bullet is loaded into it. Assume initially this is at rest. So as this is at rest, the momentum of the system, gun and bullet system, is equal to how much? Zero. Now if one fires this gun, what happens? One clicks on the trigger, what happens? Some piston pushes this bullet and the bullet moves out of the gun. So in this case, is there any external force? No. Somebody clicked on the trigger. It doesn't mean that it is external force. it is internal force only. Because of this internal force only, the bullet came out, and there is no external force on this system. As there is no external force acting on the system, the initial momentum and final momentum must be same. So here, what is our final momentum? Momentum of a gun plus momentum of bullet. That's all. Now, what is the momentum of this gun? Mass of the gun into velocity of the gun plus momentum of the bullet, means mass of bullet into velocity of the bullet. Now, in exams, generally they ask you to find the recoil velocity of the gun, means they ask you to find the VG. So similarly, in this process only we can find the VG. So initial momentum is equal to final momentum. Initial momentum is equal to zero. Final momentum means mass of gun into velocity of gun plus a mass of bullet into velocity of the bullet. So here mass of gun is equal into velocity of gun equal to mass of bullet into velocity of bullet. So if you want to find the velocity of the gun, this is called as recoil velocity of the gun. This is mass of bullet, velocity of bullet by mass of the gun. So here I have just rearranged these terms so that you will get the idea that both are same. In our worksheets, you will find some problems like an alpha particle comes out of uranium, like that. For them also the same procedure. You apply the same procedure, you will find the velocity of the remaining uranium, or you can find the mass of the remaining uranium, whatever. Okay, so this is how we can find the recoil velocities of the gun and the velocity of pieces of the bomb. Okay, now let us see another kind of problem. Imagine that two objects of masses m1 and m2 are moving with the velocities u1 and u2. Okay, in this case the initial momentum is given by pi is equal to m1 u1 plus m2 u2. Now if u1 is greater than u2 and if they are moving in the same straight line, what happens? After some time, this first object hits the second object like this, and next they will be separated and they move with different velocities again. It moves with velocity v2 and it moves with velocity v1. So this is before impact, this is during impact, and this is after impact. So the after impact, the momentum will be given by Pf is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. Here they are colliding with each other, and assume, and there is no external force acting on this system. Imagine that there is no friction at all on the surface. In such case, what happens? As there is no external force acting on the system, initial momentum is equal to final momentum. That's why m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So by using this formula, we can solve several problems. And there is a special case, that is during this heating, if they stick together, what happens? We are going to see now. For example, this is a wooden block and this is a bullet. The bullet hits the wooden block and it penetrates into it, and it will not come out of it. If they move together, then what happens? Velocity of the bullet and velocity of the block will be same. We call this as common velocity. So in such case, they move with the common velocity. We need to find the common velocity also. By using the same formula, we can find the common velocity. How? Velocity of this object is vc. Velocity of this object also vc. Because they are moving together, we say that they have common velocity. Now in place of v1, I can write vc, and in place of v2, I can write vc. Then my formula becomes m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 into vc plus m2 into vc. If I take vc common from this, what I get? Vc into m1 plus m2
is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 u2. From this v common is equal to how much? M1 u1 plus m2 u2 by m1 plus m2. So this is a standard formula. You can remember this, not a big issue. Otherwise you can remember this procedure so that you can solve any kind of problems. Is it clear? Now let us solve our worksheet. So before observing my solutions from the worksheet, you try yourself. Definitely you can solve more than 80% of the problems. If you can't, then only take my reference and go through my solutions. See you all.